You create organization charts often, then this is the video for you. I'm going to show you three efficient ways of creating org charts. One using PowerPoint, one using Excel, and one using Visio. So let's start with PowerPoint. So we start with the top. The next level of hierarchy, you press tab. And the next level, now we just have three people reporting to each other. Right click, convert to shapes, and choose org chart. So make sure this editor is open. Now, if you press enter, it's going to be at the same level, one more AVP. Now I want one more VP. Shift tab means you go backwards, and then I will type more people below this. Simple and effective. Most people want this AVP and this AVP to be horizontally next to each other. And that's a problem many people don't know how to solve. I want to solve this for both branches, so I'm going to click on VP, then press shift and click on another VP. So both are selected. Now you will see SmartArt design menu on the top. In that you can control layout and you choose standard. This is what happens. We have various options there. We have like this. We have left hanging only and we have right hanging only. So generally standard works well, but depends on what you need. So now that you have got this clear, here we have 15 types of org charts available. So this one allows you to put pictures. The next one is this, where it also allows me to put a designation there. This is another visual look and feel, another look and feel. So depending on what you're trying to depict, you choose the correct format. Now, most of them are just layout options, but these two are special. They are called labeled hierarchy. This is labeled hierarchy, horizontal. This is also labeled hierarchy, but vertical. This is top management, VP is middle management, and then AVPs are called senior managers. Where do we write that? I want bands like that. So what do? I go and choose labeled hierarchy, but now look at what it is saying. Heading one, first time it appears, is the beginning of hierarchy. All next level one appear as headings. I go here. Now this is going to be called top management. This is going to be called, and this is going to be called lower management. Now the same pattern, if you want vertically, you choose this option. Now let's see how to incorporate pictures in org charts created using PowerPoint SmartArt. This is the default SmartArt org chart layout. No problem. Go to SmartArt Design tab, go to layouts and choose this one. This allows you to incorporate pictures. There are two ways of adding a picture. If you click in the center of this placeholder, it'll ask you, where is the picture coming from? It can be local files, stock images, online, and icons. The other option is I already have pictures and I just want to copy paste them, which is what I will use to save time. So I need 8 such icons or photos. I've already got them here. So now I'm going to select a photo or a picture at a time, cut it, make sure I click on the border of the picture, and then just paste it. So that's what I'm going to do for the rest of the 7 placeholders. And with that, our org chart with pictures is ready. While we are at org charts in PowerPoint, let me also complete the topic by showing you how to animate these diagrams. First of all, change colors so that each level of hierarchy has a different color. And now I want to show them one by one. So you go to animation and let's use the simplest animation, appear. But when you run this slideshow, notice what happens. The whole diagram is shown in one click. That's not what we wanted. So apart from applying the correct animation or choosing the correct effect, you have to go to effect options. And there we have multiple options. If I choose one by one, this is what happens. Literally, it is one by one. So it goes from the top, next level, finishes that level, then goes to the next one and so on. So explore it and remember to use it the right way. So that is how you create org charts in PowerPoint. Like I said earlier, you can also create org charts efficiently using Excel or Visio. We will see those in a separate video. So that's it for now. Thank you.